Have you ever heard a hero brine? I've made this character in the intentional line. Hopefully you'll be seeing he's just gonna fall from the sky and be this visible see from the gods I'll shine. Wanna generate a map into a right hardcore and respond to Vagon.
So yeah, and of course you guys did want a lot more explosions for some reason. This is a little weird. Okay. But yeah, so let's talk about and if you guys want to get this spread out, like I said, share it on Twitter, Facebook, everything. Give it a like. That's a simple way of supporting the video. And that's basically it. Just share it to everyone. And leave your comments below with your thoughts, of course, because that's the whole point. And also, don't, like, thumbs down other people's comments, because I do check in the video about every couple hours and just write down the number one comments. So, you don't have to thumbs others down. You know, support other people's comments. You don't even have to be writing your own comment. You could go through the comments and read other people's comments and vote them up if you support them. But one thing they should add is the brand new Ender Dragon head. That would be epic. But, yeah, now, with that being said, also subscribe for new videos every single day. That would be cool if you guys could do that. But, yeah, besides that, let's talk about what I want to see in Minecraft. This is my perfect Minecraft. Okay, villagers being changed. I want to see some of the best builds. This would be cool, because when I was watching Syndicate during the winter, this was before I got back into Minecraft, because I played Minecraft January through March of 2011. Then during the summer, I played it for half of my entire summer. Then I stopped, you know, Call of Duty, Battlefield came out, and I started playing those games. Then Christmas after 1.1 came out, or 1.0 I believe, came out, I saw Syndicate's video, and he made a video where, I mean, it was staged, but he would, like, the guys added the Friar City map into his map and made it so that there was a huge adventure mode in the game where, like, a plane crash or airship crashed, and he followed it through a tunnel and it took him to a giant city. Now, I think they should add something like that. I could imagine giant, like, for one, a giant city that's not skyscraper wise but like a village town being added into Minecraft. That's a very rare thing to happen, but it randomly happens, and it's not like something that's generated. It's not like a temple that you could have in a seed. It's something that just happens that's really cool and really rare, so that people don't just share seeds. I want it to be a fun, adventurous thing that, oh my gosh, there's a city right over there, let's move in. Maybe add better AIs to Minecraft so that people can enjoy playing by themselves, because people don't enjoy villagers. They're stupid, mindless creatures. I mean, sure, they're added new AIs every now and then, but that was a stupid thing that not that many people really liked in the first place. So making villagers that are more human-like would be awesome. I've seen that in the Millionaire mod, I believe, and that was really cool. Out of biomes, add more biomes and add more variety into Minecraft, and also add more settings. I know they make Minecraft extremely easy so that people with crappy computers can play it, but there's people out there that can handle a map with a mountain from bedrock to max height, and it won't crash in Minecraft. So maybe have options for people with higher end computers to be able to use those things. Another thing I would really like to see, besides the more biomes, you know, volcanoes would be a pretty cool thing. More dungeons, more caves, more realistic caves. Now let's go to biomes. My favorite biome being the jungle. What I would like to see in there is different mob varieties. And like people kept saying, I want different mobs for different biomes, so I have a reason to go to that biome. Why do people want to go to a jungle for no reason? Maybe because they want to get themselves a cat. Or I was going to say an ocelot, but you feed that ocelot fish to get a cat. That's a reason to go to the jungle. You know, where else do you go to get a dog? You don't. It randomly happens. Where do you go to get a pig or a sheep or anything? You just find one randomly. It's not in a specific place. So if they could do that for other animals, that would be incredible. Scenery-wise, I would love to see, and mob scenery-wise, I would love to see fish. Like actual fish. Mill creatures got this right, and that's what makes fishing so much cooler. You know, I want to see fish in the water. I would like to see birds flying around. And I would like options to be able to hear birds and hear natural sounds, or to turn it off and not have to hear that. I think that'd be cool. Two flying options. Like the option that they have for, I believe it is smart movement, I think. that you could fly like Superman. That would be awesome if they could implement that into an amazing enchantment where you could actually fly vanilla mode. How that would work is you're vanilla, you drink a potion, and you could fly. You could fly kind of like this, except your body movement is Superman-like. And I think that would make people explode in amazingness. And it's like an enchantment. I think that would just be awesome. And regulate that so, of course, servers can turn it off. But I still think that'd be cool. Or maybe make it a beacon thing so that you could only do that within 100... Nah, yeah, I think within 100 blocks of your beacon. And it shows that you're getting far away from your beacon. So you don't accidentally fly, 260 blocks high and then you go one block out of your range and you fall and die. So make it a fun thing. We need more funness into Minecraft. As for jungle mobs, I would love to see crocodiles. Different varieties of them. I believe a perfect amount of this, like for crocodiles and alligators, is add an alligator, add a crocodile, add a huge Nile crocodile, add albino crocodiles, and they'll be the rare ones, of course, and then have like one giant albino crocodile that's a 1 in 1,000 chance of seeing, and it's just like ridiculously huge and really rare. I think that'd just be cool. Adding different types of fish, plus piranhas. And making it so that piranhas are like gray and reddish, but there's also regular fish that are red and grayish. So you have a risk when you jump in the water. Sometimes, you only find these in certain locations. Add caves. Now, different types of caves. Maybe it's like a giant hill biome in the jungle, and there's like a giant cave there that just leads down. And maybe it even has a river flowing through it. And it's just really vivid. There's things hanging out from the ceiling, and there's bats. That would be amazing. And by the way, this is just my crazy imagination of what Minecraft should be. And when I can get myself some people that know how to do mods and coding, we will make the best Minecraft mod. But adding it, what else would we add? Obviously primates, monkeys being one of them. And there would be a variety. We would have chimpanzees. Let me go into F5 mode. We would have chimpanzees. We would have monkeys, like capuchin monkeys. And all of them really cool monkeys and stuff. We would have gorillas. Gorillas would be pretty much in big packs. They would be big and they'd be the strongest, and they could kill you in like 2 hits if you don't have any armor on. And they live on top, they sleep at least on top of trees, not very high up, but they have like their little nests, and they can climb just like all of the other creatures. They can climb from vine to vine, and it's pretty cool. Now of course, capuchin monkeys being smaller, and you can actually become, you could kind of get them like you do with dogs. Maybe you feed them a banana and they'll be like your helper monkey, and they could assist you in certain things. I don't know, I think that'd be cool. Adding howler monkeys as well, and another regular type of monkey. So there's the capuchin, the regular, and the howler, and the howler just makes type of noises all night sometimes, or no, in the mornings, kind of like a jungle wake up. It's not like default, but it's like if you're within range. I think that'd be cool. And of course, able to turn it off in the settings and it'd be fine. Adding beautiful birds like pecans and parrots, I think that'd be cool. And maybe making it so that like a parrot will make the same noise that it hears. So for example, if you see a parrot and you have like a dog and it makes a bark noise, the parrot will go bark, bark, Or maybe you have a bow and you shoot it, the parrot will make the same noise. I don't know. I think that'd be pretty cool. Or maybe you could just teach it to say words but make it gibberish so it fits. I don't know. I think that would be awesome. Another thing that they should add into jungles. Now these are just basic stuff to add. There's a lot more variety, snakes being one of them. I'm trying to think of something incredible for jungles. Oh my gosh. Cats. Obviously add more varieties. Jaguars. We've got jungle tigers. I don't know. Awesome things like that would be really cool to see. Now, I don't want to get too carried away. Let's go into... Oh, one thing. Sharks. I want to be able to see... For example, bull sharks. Bull sharks are sharks that can be in the ocean, but they also go upstream, and you will see them sometimes in the Nile River, but in the Amazon rivers and things like that, I believe, or I'm going a little bit stupid. But I know that in America, I've seen documentaries about bull sharks being found in rivers. So I think that'd be cool. I think it should be a very rare chance of seeing a shark. Like for example, a bull shark are... Let's make it so that sharks can randomly be found in rivers, but only bull sharks, because there's only ones that could go from sea to regular riverland, or saltwater to freshwater. But I think that would be cool to be able to see that. I would also like variety in water textures, kind of like how swamps have their own texture. I would like to see that in jungles. I would like to see it so that's reflective or mucky. There's two varieties of that. And waterfalls, like really good mountain waterfalls. That would be awesome too. And lagoons. And yeah, that's like my crazy jungle right there. Now in the oceans, obviously sharks. If I could pick four default sharks, great white shark, you find it in the middle, in the middle of the ocean, and they jump out. I think that would be epic, and they're huge. Bull sharks. I already said what they are. They can go into the ocean and into the rivers, and they're really vicious creatures. And they're not that big, but they can get pretty decent sized. Tiger sharks, because they're awesome, and hammerhead sharks. Now we could also add a couple more, but I think that'd be cool. If I could add another one, I would add a tiny little one that you could actually put inside a fish tank that you can man-make. And by a fish tank, I mean a glass box that's decent size, and you could put a shark in there. I think that'd be cool. Another thing, for oceans, giant squid, maybe. Like a kraken type of thing, I think that'd be cool. Definitely whales, definitely dolphins, definitely more variety of fish and bigger fish. Like, I'm trying to think. Sailfish would be awesome. Swordfish, things like that would be really cool. A sawfish would be awesome as well. Stingrays, manta rays, devil rays, all those things would be great aspects. Jellyfish, and this would all be spread out through the different areas of an ocean. Some of these you could find in a beach. Some of these you have to go extremely deep into an ocean. And I think like a giant squid would be something that you should be able to find deep, deep in the ocean. So for example, you might see a couple of sharks and randomly a giant squid attacks them. And if you shoot the squid, maybe like in the eye, it'll paralyze it to the point where it won't be able to go down because it'll be disoriented. I know this isn't that realistic, but in order to make it possible for you to get a giant squid, I think that would be cool. I don't know how that would really work. Maybe you like drag it with a fishing rod. I want to add different fishing rods to Minecraft. Maybe add like an iron one, and there's the regular one we have now. And then possibly, I was thinking about like diamond and emerald one, but I don't know. I think for now, having an iron one for bigger fishing. Like maybe you could get two types of boats. You can get a boat made out of iron, so its texture is a little weird, but it basically handles the same. And that way you can go fishing in the ocean and deep sea fishing, you can handle bigger fish. For example, let's say you have a smaller wooden boat. If you go deep into the ocean with a smaller wooden boat, you can get attacked by a shark, like a gray white. And a gray white won't kill you, it'll just knock you into the water. And once you're in the water, after 8 seconds of being in the water, you can start getting attacked. I think that'd be cool. And if you have an iron boat, it won't do that, but you still will get bumped. But let's say you're fishing for a big sailfish on a wooden fishing pole, it'll break. If you're fishing with an iron fishing pole, it won't break. But it could like yank you out of your boat. So if you have an iron boat, you'll be fine. I think that'd be cool. Just imagine that. Fishing adventures. And that would be so much fun. Add new textures, I guess, to the fishing rods. That'd be pretty cool. And yeah, that's that. There's probably also sea turtles, which I forgot to talk about. And a few little things. But I can't talk about everything or I will forget. As for mountains, maybe add a yeti or bear type of things. I don't know. Of course, make it so that the default animals now have different textures per biome. So, you know, maybe a warthog for a Sahara or something like that, or a desert, I'm going to say. In the desert, make it so that there is a mob there. Maybe like little scorpions that you see. Or maybe add like a lion. Like a lion pride. Something cool like that. For villagers, make it so that villages now are bumped out. And I'm not talking about the cities. I'm talking about like a regular village now would have different types of villagers. There's like the regular villagers we have now, and then we would have like maybe another type, maybe bigger towns with more things to them. I don't know, I think that'd be cool. Maybe the villagers even have dogs and cats. So that's another thing to add to the game. Decoration blocks, Jeb is doing a great job. Jeb and Netherbone are doing a great job with that. Maybe add a few little more things. Definitely dyeable beds, definitely couches, seats, things like that would be incredible to add into Minecraft. As for mountains and volcanoes, add a little adventure to that. And there's just a lot more things I could keep on mentioning about what I should or what I think that Minecraft could be insane if they could do. And a lot of these things will be added throughout Minecraft's lifetime, but they're not going to add everything at once, or else Minecraft will just be like, oh, it's amazing, it ain't going to get any better than this, and it'll die out. That's why game developers don't do so much. That's why they make Modern Warfare 2 and Modern Warfare 3 and then Black Ops 2. You know, why don't they just straight up go to the best game? Because it's also about keeping the game alive for a long time, you know? So I think there's that. And of course, there's the mod API being changed so that mods basically replace updates. But there still will always be updates. So, I mean, I just think this would be an amazing Minecraft either update or mod. So, if any of you mod designers are out there, listen to the community and your mod will be the best. Because that's what Mo Creatures did, that's what Flames mods did, or I forgot what to call it. But, yeah, guys, just keep that in mind, and I will make another part to this in the future when I organize every thought in my head, and I will be taking more surveys with my friends, and I'll be reading all of your comments. So, look forward to a follow-up to this video, which is just going to be everything that I thought of with a little bit of your guys, and of course, look for the official video of what I just said, because there's a difference between a follow-up and the official one. A follow-up will be just an extension of everything that I was just ranting on about that they should add, and the official one would be basically what I would like to send to Jeb and Dinnerbone with your support, saying, hey, this is what the community voted, these are the people that are looking at the snapshots that want to have changes, listen to their changes, these are the number one things that they want, you know, maybe add that for a change. I think that'd be cool. So yeah, I'm gonna get working on that. I'm also gonna go ahead and make a news video about the snapshot 12W30 8A with all the things that are gonna be in it as far as we know right now. And look forward to that, guys. Hit the annotation on the bottom left to go to my channel or just scroll through my videos and look at the latest videos. And that's basically it. Leave a comment with your thoughts, suggestions, everything. Give the video a like, send it to all your friends, and subscribe for new videos every single day. I'm SlayRock36, and I will talk to you guys later. Bye.